th and th. A bit further back in the mouth, but still frontal enough to be able to see and feel the speech organs at work, we have th and th. This time I'll supplement the zoomed-in camera with a diagram, a cross-section of the speech organs. Here's the nose, here's the tongue, and here are the top teeth. The place of articulation for th is highlighted in red. To make th, the tongue touches the top teeth. Th. As with f, it's impossible to make complete closure because of the gaps between our teeth, so the air rushes out fast with friction noise. So th is another fricative. Is th voiced? Th. No. There's no vibration of the vocal folds, so it's voiceless. It's a voiceless dental fricative. Th is always spelt th, and its IPA transcription is the Greek letter theta. Th is an unusual sound in the world's languages. Most languages do not have it. Arabic, Standard Castilian Spanish and Greek are notable exceptions, but it's a relatively rare sound and likely to be difficult for many learners. Here are some examples of th in initial position. Thin. Thin. Think. Think. Thaw. Thaw. Thought. Thought. Thief. Thief. Thatch. Thatch. Through. Through. Three. Three. Thread. Thread. In medial position. Something. Something. Nothing. Nothing. Pathway. Pathway. Healthy. Healthy. Wealthy. Wealthy. Python. Python. And in final position. Bath. Bath. Cloth. Cloth. Moth. Moth. Both. Both. Tooth. Tooth. Teeth. Teeth. North. North. South. South. Th. Th is the voiced equivalent of th. It's dental in place, it's fricative, and the vocal folds vibrate. Th. So it's a voiced dental fricative. Like th, th is always written th, and it's not always 100% obvious whether a particular th is going to be th or the. Some examples of th in initial position. This. That. There. Then. Though. So I said that spelling doesn't tell us whether we have a th or a th in any particular place, but look at those words. This, that, then, there, and though. All pronounced with voiced th. How do these words differ from those with a voiceless th at the beginning? Thin. Think. Thought. Thaw and thief. The words with voiceless th are all lexical words. They're adjectives, nouns, verbs. Whereas those with voiced th are all grammatical words. They're pronouns, conjunctions and some adverbs. The th words are an open class with a very large number of examples, whereas the th words are a closed class. There are only a few words beginning the in the whole language. In fact, we can list all the words beginning with the easily. They are than, that, the, the, there, them, themselves, there, therefore, therein, these, and they. And words with they in them, like there and they'll. This, those, thou, though, and thy. I think that's all of them. Tell us in the comments if you can think of any more. And some examples of the in medial position. Mother, mother. Brother, brother. Bother, bother. Rather, rather. Lather, lather. Smother, smother. Weather, weather. Either, either. Gather, gather. Other, other. Leather, leather. The letters TH in the middle of a word is far more likely to be voiced the than voiceless th. There are very few examples of th in the middle of a word, and most of these are compound words, like toothache and pathway. There are loads of words with medial the. And now the in final position. Teeth. Teeth, the noun, becomes the verb to teeth. Wreath. A wreath, the noun, of flowers, becomes the verb to wreathe, meaning to encircle, as in the smoke wreathes around my nostrils and makes me sneeze. And the plural of the noun wreath is also wreaths. The noun mouth gives us the verb to mouth, and the plural of mouth is mouths. The noun sheath gives us the verb to sheath, and the plural of sheath is sheaths. Singular path becomes plural paths. To loathe, the verb meaning to hate or to detest, and related to it we have loath, L-O-T-H or L-O-A-T-H, loath, which is an adjective meaning unwilling. I was loath to tell her, but I felt I had to. Breathe. Breath, the noun, becomes the verb to breathe. But the plural of breath, surprisingly, is breaths. Bathe. Bath, the noun, becomes the verb to bathe. The plural of bath is unusual. It can be either baths or baths. So th and the are difficult sounds for many learners, and there are several different ways they may be mispronounced. French speakers typically substitute s and z for them. Turkish and German speakers may substitute t and d. Even though Spanish has both sounds, Spanish speakers may still have trouble with them, pronouncing the sounds correctly but in the wrong places, influenced by the use of the letters c and z in Spanish. And d. Even native speakers of English are not immune to mispronouncing the dental fricatives, in this case substituting f and v. It's common amongst a certain sort of native speaker to pronounce th as f, as in free instead of three, and path instead of path, and to say v instead of the in places other than the start of a word, so rather, rather than rather. We've all heard people, usually big tough people, who say one, two, three. Both of them was there. I definitely saw both of them. My big brother will come and deal with you if you don't shut up. Don't do it. It may be native speak. It's certainly common among lower social classes in and around London, but it's not going to give a good impression if you want to sound professional. It's a heavily stigmatised pronunciation. It sounds most unprofessional. TH, whether it's th or the, must always be dental. It can be a very weak sound, but the tongue must touch the teeth. F and V are labiodental, the lip and the teeth in contact. F should never in any circumstances be substituted for th, and V never replaces the. Some examples contrasting F and th. Watch my lips. Fought, thought. First, thirst. Free, three. Half, hearth. Deaf, death. Oath, oath. And V contrasted with the. That, that. Van, than. Live, lithe. Clothes, cloves. Sheaves, sheaths. Another mispronunciation is d for the. You will certainly hear this among certain groups of speakers, but again, don't copy. Just because someone does it and calls themselves a native speaker does not mean you should copy or regard it as acceptable. The dental sounds should be dental. Anything else is stigmatized and sounds unprofessional. We'll contrast the and d when we do d in the next lesson. Now some practice sentences with the and the. 13 thirsty thinkers thought thankfully of great things in Thanet. 13 thirsty thinkers thought thankfully of great things in Thanet. And you repeat that. 13 thirsty thinkers thought thankfully of great things in Thanet. Thrifty, threadbare therapists theorising on theocracy. Thrifty, threadbare therapists theorising on theocracy. And repeat. Thrifty, threadbare therapists theorising on theocracy. This is the weather that thoroughly thick-skinned northerners like. This is the weather that thoroughly thick-skinned northerners like. And repeat. This is the weather that thoroughly thick-skinned northerners like. Thank goodness they've gone. I began to think they'd never go. Thank goodness they've gone. I began to think they'd never go. And repeat. Thank goodness they've gone. I began to think they'd never go. Th and the.